boys and girls, London calling. Now don't look to us, phony Beatlemania has bitten the dust. London calling, see we ain't got no swing except for the rain and the crunch of thing. The ice is coming, the sun's zooming in. Meltdown expected, the wheat is going thin. Engines stop running, but I have no fear, 'cause London is drowning. I live by the river.
Right, you're under arrest.
The Link Road runs alongside Cambridge Park, under Blakehall Road, goes under the new Green Man interchange, crosses the central line, and then runs alongside the central line through Leytonstone and Leighton.
Basically, the motorway carves right through three boroughs and displaces people. Removes local housing stock, isolates local shops. It will probably bankrupt half of the high street shops.
Our MP, Harry Cohen, went to see Steve Norris, and Steve Norris said, he acknowledged that the whole concept behind the M11 Link Road is out of date, but he's pushing on regardless. Well, he ain't going to push it on over us. Yeah. That's because the Department of Transport are wetting their drawers against People Power. People Power got the Lerma out of Sarajevo. People Power stopped Oxley's Wood, and People Power is going to stop the M11 Link Road. Yeah. What they care about is people stopping their plans, and we're going to stop their plans.
Watch yourself.
We've gained occupation. We've got the security guards out. The security guards had to leave. The police agreed that there was no case for preventing us from doing this, and they all cleared off eventually. So now we've spent the afternoon repairing the roof because they'd stripped most of the timber decking and the tiles off. And so we've broken down the barricade outside, and we've used the corrugated iron from the barricade to just sheath the roof.
Thank you.
If you've got any problems at all, I suggest you speak to the DOT.
Oh, yeah.
Right. It was repossessed this morning. Hold on, I'm speaking to this bloke. It was repossessed this morning under a court order,
mm-hmm.
and that's the end of it.
And this was someone's home for years and years and years. And somebody lived their life here. Someone made a success or a failure of themselves from this house. And so a few people can get across East London a few minutes quicker. The Ministry of Transport think that they've got the right to just destroy all of that. To just take that away. And one of the things they claim is that it'll be better for the community. How can destroying homes be better for a community?
So we can start doing a bit of work here now. Yes, so I've just got to get a stool. Just there.
That window, because there's a roof leading right out to it, and they can just stand in it and bat a fuck out of it.
Fair enough, but that the big ball we got there, it's going to be the flat ball.
Yeah.
That the last people get in. That's a good first line, and then we can put some buttresses up.
And then we can put some buttresses up and tin and stuff. We should keep we should keep a sheet of tin for that one.
Yeah, there is one in there.
Right, because that's the one they're going to come through, I reckon.
This is a handcuff. This is what you have to do to try and stay in your house when they're coming in here to take you out. One of us puts a hand in this side. One in the other side, click a small handcuff in the middle so as our hands are joined. That's the only way, as a last resort, that we can stay in here. They said they'd give us £1,500 moving money if we stay in there and let them come in and trash your own house. So how's that for a... How's that for blackmail? Yeah. You're a person, not... Oh. They think it is that means something to them. They're spiritually bankrupt. They think that a bit of money. They could offer me 15 grand, 30 grand. They could offer me 100 grand. 100,000 pound, that is. And they'll have to take me off the roof first. Well, they'll have to take the people out of the house first. There's no one going to do it.
Yeah.
No one going to do it. Just not anymore. Not when you see your own area destroyed.
It's just insane. Hello?
Yeah.
We shouldn't be having to do this. We should be sort of doing things we like doing. Barricading myself into houses.
No, it's like creating houses, isn't it?
Yeah, we should be
for that. I'll just like put that one out in the garden. Out the back window, bring us a bit of luck.
This is the guy who he was talking about the wasp's nest upstairs, and most people would just be talking about how they could destroy it. So he's saying, well, come the winter, he'd build a little thing around it so they could have access, but so that if he wanted to live in the loft, he could live in the loft, and he'd build a little cordon around the wasp's nest so that they'd be safe.
Again. I need
mess if we don't change our minds pretty soon.
See what was common land being fenced in for a road really provoked a feeling of anger and distress amongst the local community, and in some ways a feeling of helplessness as to what you could do against this type of road construction.
Move off site, please. Yeah, the fence is up. It's privately owned land. You can leave the property, please. You are now trespassing. Can you leave the property, please?
Excuse me, sir, you're trespassing. Can you please leave?
Went home with my two children because I felt the atmosphere could get a bit nasty when there were quite a few police turned up. I then realised about an hour later my oldest son wasn't around. I came back looking for him and found him pushing down the fences, having been told that he was climbing on the diggers. And I thought I can do one of two things. I can take him away, I can get cross with him and tell him off. On the other hand, I could do what I really felt and joined in. So I joined in.
Put in mind of the people's revolt and the people of Wanstead who originally retook Epping Forest a couple of hundred years ago when it was first enclosed. Things go in cycles, and we're back again, the people of Wanstead and Leytonstone empowered and taking their land back.
Chestnut, oh, witch hazel. Yeah, can we bring some more information? People are requesting it at the tree. Yeah, Roger, can you bring some like hot drinks for people at the rear? I was nine.
Thank you. of course, underneath this green runs the infamous central line, and over the last few days of November 93, there has been this dreadful collapse. The whole system has failed because they want to put millions of pounds into building a road here, yet they're not prepared to renew a few old cables that were put in 50 years ago on the central line. So you have a complete system that is failing on one hand, yet you're building more and more roads on the other.
Yeah,
where's the logic? There isn't it.
And it's not just the fact that it's a road, it's the fact that there's going to be little children out playing like they usually do. And it's going to be, I mean, it's bad enough trying to cross there as it is. When they build all this motorway around, it's going to be terrible, it's going to be impossible to cross.
I had intended to live out my days and see my family grow up around me in Wanstead, but I'm not going to do that now. I don't believe it will be possible to live in peace, in any kind of pleasant atmosphere in this area any longer. This road will destroy what was one of the nicer little villages on the eastern edge of London. It's an appalling mess, it's an appalling shame. And I don't understand why anybody can think that this thing is going to do anything for anybody except big business. And yes, I believe it's being driven by money, basically. It's being driven by money and government stupidity.
Just come back from an ex parte injunction that we obtained yesterday, where we actually made a tree house into a dwelling in effect, and therefore prevented the DOT from unlawfully evicting them, the people living in it, for this gentleman here. That's the first time in history, as far as we're aware, that a tree house has been deemed a dwelling and such an action has actually succeeded.
What's it like living in a tree?
Very comfortable actually. We've got a double bed up there and a double hammock and a kitchen, heating. We've got everything up that we need. We've
got a little kitchenette in there and yeah, it's really lovely. It's lovely waking up in a tree. It's a nice feeling. I can't explain it really. You have to experience it to understand it.
Don't worry about falling out of bed or something.
No, no, not no at way.
All. Okay, thanks very much.
Thanks.
Okay.
Bye.
Well done.
If I quit now, if I died tomorrow, I could not believe a beautiful wind like that. There was... No, I couldn't. I'm not joking. For people so decent, and for people so committed, for people so deserving of protection, I could not believe it. And it was the guy who wrote... I don't know if you've seen the letter from Cheshire. This guy wrote a letter to the people in the tree, and they've even got a letterbox in the tree. Right, in a door, front door on the tree, proved it was a dwelling, right? That proved our case that it was a dwelling, it wasn't a joke, and we turned it round from judges thinking it was a joke. And that's the most beautiful thing ever. I tell you, that man who, he's Ian someone or other, I've got it on my papers, but that man deserves a medal.
I'm here to find out what's happened with the court case.
Right.
Inside. We still don't know the exact news yet. All we know is that we've lost part of it.
The judge granted the department a possession order for all the land that we're entitled to on George Green.
Shame!
And what exactly does that mean, Mr. Tilley?
That means that we're now entitled to go in to carry out works for construction of the link road.
Does it mean the people who live in the tree at the moment will be off that site within a very short space of time?
Yes.
It does? What sort of time scale are you talking about, Mr. Tilley?
I can't say precisely, but the department's anxious to get on with the work as quickly as possible.
Yeah, I'm there.
And we're all obeying orders.
Yeah.
Do you mind?
Yes.
Could you just say quiet for one minute, please?
No, I mean, this is London they're knocking down. I mean, it is our business.
Yeah, I know, but would you mind staying quiet just for 5 minutes?
Well, so that he can come out with all this Department of Transport propaganda. It's ridiculous. You know, they're just coming to a neighbourhood, throwing everybody out, they're destroying a community. And it's very ironic that yesterday was November the 11th, when we're supposed to celebrate what a lot of very brave men and women died for. Well, what did they die for? They didn't die so that whole communities could be erased.
It's not the first time that attacks like this have been met on Claremont. There's been many attacks, but this is the worst one yet. Yeah, most of the cars here have been smashed. This one here on the right-hand side of us has been burnt out. I mean, these cars are not exactly piles of junk. They're very decent cars. And the damage that has been done here tonight is mind-taking.
We've just arrived here approximately 10 minutes ago to complete devastation. It appears that whilst two people were sitting around the campfire, four men were seen approaching from behind the bender in the foreground there. Two men were seen approaching from the road area. They proceeded to firebomb the bender, which at the time contained six people who were lucky to escape with their lives. The people are very demoralized at the moment and very worried in many ways as well. So somebody has resorted to these type of tactics just shows what complete cowards they are.
Hello, is that Kate? Hello, it's Tim here from the M11 campaign, ringing about the phone tree, which I don't know if you know about. We've got you provisionally marked, if you'd be happy, as being a branch on the phone tree. Is that okay? What a branch means you're responsible for your fruit, and your fruit are three people, and what will happen is the trunk will
M11
ring you, which is
fruity.
You have someone who has your number and several others. And he will give you a ring if there's any urgent situation by the tree.
My husband's family have been here since 1880 in Wanstead, and we felt we had to come to support the people that are trying to save our tree.
Four of us are chained together around the tree using these metal steel tubes that you can see here, and we're locked together inside the tube, so they can't move us unless they hacksaw through the tube, which is going to take us some hours.
What's been going on? We've just found out that they're moving in. Somebody appears to be trying to block our channel on CD, and Mayhem's backbreaking time out. Hello, Chestnut. Hello, Chestnut.
The aim of our actions is to ensure that the majority of us peacefully blockade their actions around the tree. If they remove you, try and go back in again. Yeah, don't force your way, try. Don't run. Don't shout abuse, yeah? Some of these people actually agree with us.
There you go. It's the same. The tree is extremely close to the fan.
Hold of me, smashed my glasses, and stamped on me, and then threw me down.
Let him go!
I was
peacefully protesting, and a policeman turned around and punched me in the mouth.
Guilty of violence against the earth and against women.
That one there, that police officer there, he was kicking away like mad. That one, that is the officer.
This has been one of the most disgusting examples of police state brutality that I've ever seen. And the only hope I have as a result of that is that it will all go well for us. We are going to win this campaign. This road will never be built. And this violence tonight will harden the resolve, certainly of people like myself. And I'm not the only one around here who has been sick to the gut to see these cowards beating people up under the cover of darkness.
We got to have the bloody road, you don't. Why don't you piss off where you bloody came from?
You're obsolete. You're already history. No more you need come through, because your children are ours. They see what really goes down now.
Oh, you unclean trap!
Stop it!
Stop it!
It's dreadful. I mean, I don't know whether I'm the best person to talk to. I'm not political, I'm just a Wanstead resident.
Where? flag's bolted.
Going to court this afternoon to face my first eviction. Basically, I was asked on the 30th of December to leave this property, or at least my brother was, because he is actually the leaseholder. I left rather reluctantly because I thought that would suit his convenience, but I was very happy to say that after we'd actually left the house, some very kind squatters moved in from the No M11 Link Road campaign. And I thought to myself, they seem a nice bunch, so I moved back in with them. So it's really sad to see the way the house is actually going. It's a very beautiful house, built in 1904, and it says a lot about style and individuality. And I think that also sums up a lot of people in this campaign.
He destroyed George Green and the trees. Now they want to destroy these beautiful houses, and this is just the start of it. They're going to destroy another 350 houses along the route, and hopefully there'll be more independent states springing up along the route, and we hope to inspire people all around the country and hope that they set up their own independent states, because they want to remove themselves from this this countrywide dictatorship of development and unnecessary road building.
Here we have a four-person lock-on chimney stack with two tubes going through either side. And when the eviction happens, we'll all rush up to the roof, and these will be used inside. Shove your hand in. one person the other side with one of these. You knock on to a bar which is in the middle of the tube, and the only way the police can get you out is if they cause you an inordinate amount of pain by pulling your arm, and that is basically breaking the law. The other way is takes a long time, which is to dismantle the whole chimney stack.
We're not totally sure anything we do will stop them completely. I mean, hopefully, it'd be nice if it did. But people worked out where diggers were likely to come through around the back of the houses and planned these trenches to sort of try and stop them, basically. Hopefully they won't be able to get through. If they do, it'll have taken them longer, which will give us more time to lock on and get media in, get solicitors around, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I know, but door's going to be secured quite quickly. Are you going upstairs, mate?
No, I'm going upstairs, the other
okay,
house.
We're going to close the door, so you want to get out quite soon.
I'm just looking for a pair of gloves here.
A lot of hard work's gone into this, into barricading this room over the past week and a half. This wall here has been barricaded and fit in the cavity filled with concrete, and the same with that wall there. And the windows have been filled with concrete, and the ceiling has been heavily barricaded, and rafters have been put in place to secure all the barricades.
Yeah, the memories of the house, I mean, 13 years is a long time. If you look at it, it's quite a grand house, but they'll be coming in the morning. All we can do is what we're doing. We'll fight them all the way.
Sheeting in front of the six homes in Cambridge Park here in Wanstead, while dozens of protesters sit and jeer on the roofs. There's a huge police presence, and they've cordoned off the whole area of Wanstead. Up to 700 officers are involved. And just now, the High Court Sheriff John Hargrove has again used a megaphone to instruct the protesters to leave. Now that gesture has just been met with jeers. In December, George's Green in Wanstead was the focus of the anti-road protest when a 250-year-old Sweet Chestnut was felled. Today's action is likely to be just as protracted and cost thousands of pounds.
Hi, Mum, it's Becca. Hiya, have you heard all the news? Oh, it's happening. It's happening in a really, really big way. There's 800 police here.
It's happening in a really, really big way. If you switch on the news and switch on the radio, and you'll be able to hear it.
Apparently it's costing 200,000 so far. The news. Which is pretty good. Yeah.
They've got the cherry picker up to the side window, that side of the building, and they can get through.
It's going to get really, really hectic. I mean, basically they're like clearing the houses out of all the people who aren't locked onto things. There's about 8 people in one house locked on and about 4 in another house, and then there's 2 of us in this house.
The siege appears to be drawing to a close. Sheriff's officials coming down through the roof. Police trying to get through the barricaded door behind me.
Hands through the floor.
Hands through the floor.
Look.
Yeah, the gentleman outside had handcuffs on, but he could release them himself. So I'm asking you, do you want to release it yourself, or do you want to suffer pain until you release it yourself? Because we can use a necessary amount of force.
What do you mean, it's painful force?
It will be painful. It won't be painful for me.
Are you sure it won't?
Do you enjoy doing it? I don't enjoy it at all. That's why I'm giving you. If I enjoyed it, I'd just hang your arm down, wouldn't I? Giving you the option.
I work for an independent film company.
Yeah, that's all right.
I just want to film so that I can show what actually happens in here.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. I'm now asking you to leave. But being in such a confined space, you'll be injuring our duty. So I'm going to ask you to leave.
Because just minimal force means that they can give us pain. You said so.
I'm asking you to leave now, please.
The ice age is coming. The sun's zooming in. Engines stop running. The wind is going to be a nuclear arrow. But I have no fear, 'cause London is drowning out. I live by the river. Oh.
it was true. Rumbling golly at the top of the dial. And after all this, won't you give me a smile?
We're going to fight every blade of grass, as they say. We're going to go all the way.
After Wanstonia, there was a lot of energy around, and I think Wanstonia itself gathered quite a lot of support and pulled people into the campaign. And that went into organising Operation Roadblock, which was a month of direct action at the work sites every day. And people came in from all over the country. They'd put themselves on a rota to say what day they were coming down. And it was, the idea was to get 100 people a day down, which it was very successful.
I can get up more easily than most people can without crutches.
So, can you tell us, Ellie, are you occupying this manhole?
Yes. Well, no, we were invited to sit here by the good gentleman who's digging it. They're having their lunch break, and they said we could sit here. So we are sitting here.
OK. Are you all right?
Use our shoulders.
All right.
It's not good.
Yeah, that's what I bunk up.
Keep it fluffy! Yeah! Go, go, go!
I'm just telling you officially that if you don't get off the road, then you'll be arrested in due course for causing highway obstruction.
Do you understand? It's actually between us and
you. You have your warning.
All the time they're building more and more roads, they're killing people and they don't even realise it, they're making people homeless. And unless people come out like ourselves and stand up to them and say, look, it's not on, we're not going to let you get away with it, then like the country's going to be covered in concrete by the year 2000. There's going to be no green spaces for no one to go to.
I usually lock on here every Wednesday.
Oh, they strong. She goes on and on and on. The spirit. She is like a mountain. She goes on and on, you can't kill the spirit. She is like a mountain, old and strong. She goes on and on, you can't kill the spirit. She is like a mountain, old and strong. She goes on and on.
We actually took 6 days to do the whole house. We decided to have a limited time and do it intensively, so we invited people to come between certain dates. Just got loads and loads of paint and set to. But it's quite an experience seeing it transform in such a small amount of time. This was done by Steve, who is someone that's been involved in the campaign for a long time. And he did this project quite a long time ago, before the art house. But it's such a nice thing. We thought it'd be good to have it on display in here. It's a bit battered because it's been well used. It's been outside the High Court and to Megatropolis and all over the place. Mm. And it's a picture of every house that was standing at the time that he took the photographs, which was quite a long time ago. And a lot of these houses don't exist anymore. But it's a good record. This is the bathroom, and it was completely done by Lisa, who lives in Claremont Road. She's a resident that's lived here for about 10 years, I think. And she thinks that the road is money going down the drain, basically, and that roads all over the place are like horrible snakes. Messing up the planet. I think that's basically the message of this piece. This drawing is by Mary, who lives in one of the houses which is going to get knocked down. And it leads you into the room that I did, and it reminds you, the writing on the wall reminds you that every step you take is sacred. At the moment, I think the house is creating a good kind of positive focus, because there's so much destruction around the place. Every day you see another house get knocked down, and people come here who are very angry. There's a lot of very angry people around. And this house is like a sort of a positive statement, kind of help redress the balance and give somewhere, and also to give people who want to really do a positive thing, to give those people a chance to express themselves.
Well, I live in Claremont Road. I've been living there for 3.5 years, and they're planning to put a motorway through my house and others, so I basically don't want it to happen. I'm expressing my point peacefully.
I can't really blame you for being a little bossy. The thing to do is not to.
They'd rather block their daylight out in their bedroom, apparently, with this big banner. They might have overslept, thinking it was still dark. Their security was certainly asleep. Taken completely by surprise and greeted with a peaceful protest on their roofs, without any cherry pickers, chainsaws, brutal smashing of slates, offensive smashing your front door down. We didn't do none of that to MacGreggor. Just peaceably sat fairly quietly on the roof.
Homes not roads! Homes not roads! Homes not roads! Homes not roads!
Save our country!
The original weed of wisdom, healing our nation.
To put us all to sleep, a kind of waking sleep, where you go to work if you've got a job, where you stay docile if you haven't, where you don't question what you're told, you're grateful for what's given to you, and you accept the world as it appears to be, with all the inequality, discrimination and suffering that's involved. But people here have woken up. We can see it, even if some of them people in Parliament have a problem seeing it. And we have a different set of values that we're here celebrating today. And this is not just a march, this is a celebration of our belief in equality, diversity and personal sovereignty, the right to be different. Stage 5 of this bill is going to make it far easier to make criminals of us all. Not only the dispossessed, the oppressed, us, but we're also the new culture, the creative sparks, the real green shoots of recovery. We are the only alternative to a system which is trying to use the world's resources as fast as they can with no bloody clue of what to do in the future. In the last 2 years, we've seen the catalyst of peaceful, direct action change the road attitude, change the population's attitude to transport. Yeah. A big hand, yeah, for people at Twyford, for Bongos, for M11 people.
Of tomorrow must be allowed to defend their village greens from the ravages of progress without being turned into criminals. We must pledge to continue our protests even if this iniquitous bill becomes law later this summer. The issues about which we're protesting are simply too important for us to do anything less.
Where cars just drive up and down and kind of people are forced onto the pavement and, you know, people just kind of pass each other in a rush on the way to work. And that all started to change at CLAREMONT ROAD. And like John said, we reclaimed the street and the inside of the houses actually came onto the street, and so life sort of stopped being so atomised. And also at the same time, there was the kind of protest against the criminal justice bill was building up. And so people were kind of starting to see this as a part of a kind of wider struggle. It wasn't just about the M11 Link Road, it was about a much kind of wider struggle.
It was her home for more than half a century, but today Ellen Layton left for the last time. The 78-year-old was stretchered out by ambulance men after bailiffs turned up armed with sledgehammers.
They just turned up and said, we open the door, and I said, hang on a minute, and bang, in comes the front door.
Mrs. Layton was taken to hospital, but later released.
And she's 78, got a weak heart, and they spent the next half an hour or so trying to sort of like stabilise her.
Oh no, not Richard. Why didn't he tell us? He's got his phone, his mobile phone.
He didn't know. He was woken up with sledgehammers on his door.
They promised they'd give him one day's notice. Richard!
I mean, Richard had the guts to just stick it out, and he paid a very, very high price for that. But he said, you can't really, because his dad was campaigning against this road. It's been going on for so long, his dad, years and years ago, was campaigning against this road. And Richard's view is, I know, that you can't really say you're against the road and then meekly take the money and go and hide somewhere and say, well, I'm all right, Jack. You know, and it was suggested to Richard that perhaps he should have looked after his mum and got her to safety, but his mum has a mind of her own. When she was asked what she wanted to do if the bailiffs came, she said, sod them, they'll have to drag me out, which is exactly what they did.
We very much regret that it came to this. We had given the Laytons every opportunity to go in a peaceful way, but they refused.
But the biggest operation of all is probably still to come. Here in CLAREMONT ROAD, protesters are occupying an entire row of terraced houses. No one here will leave willingly.
This moment.
the rafters on the tower we're now standing on isn't all that sturdy, and I don't have the key for either locks. So basically, if this thing falls, I'm dead.
What's she been arrested for?
Oh, mate!
What was the last war we were fighting for our freedom? Sounds a bit affected, but it wasn't, so I've lived through it. What are we doing now, anyway? I'm fighting for my freedom. I'm trying to fight for my freedom, but I'm not getting very far.
You're in a bunker that's been built in one of the houses. Originally, we were going to sink it right the way down to the ground, so that the top would be flush with the ground level. But unfortunately, we hit the water table to about 3.5 feet. So the first 3 feet or so of the bunker is actually underground, and then the remaining 6 feet or so is above ground. And we've put all floorboarding planks around the outside and on the top, and made it as strong as we possibly can with supporting joists. And then all the room on the outside of the bunker has been filled with various unmentionable stuff that we found in the gardens, including things like fridges, cookers, radiators, and all that sort of junk. And the idea is that on the day, since they've been able to drag you out of an empty room, they've actually got to dig you out of more or less out of a tomb. There will be food and water down here, so if they decide to starve them out, they can actually hold out for a few days.
The Leighton end of the route needed to be put on the map in terms of what was being lost here, because most of the housing, most of the 250 houses that are going to be destroyed because to make room for the link, are from the Leighton end. You know, the whole streets like Dyot Hall Road have been totally decimated, Colville Road, Grove Green Road, Station Road. You know, all these roads that have just been totally bulldozed and decimated as if they never existed. And all the efforts that have been put on, put into barricading, protecting, to painting up, to you know, publicising Claremont Road, celebrating Claremont Road and 100 years of history that's embodied in them. Yeah, so it just wouldn't go unnoticed, really, that people will remember.
Nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. Against the famine and the crown, you rebelled it roughly down. Now you must raise a child up in dignity. Long lie the fields of Adonrath.
Tea without sugar? Tabs. One here for you.
Yeah. Who is the next?
What
have
we got here?
Mike, how come every house you live in gets evicted?
Because the bailiffs take a particular delight in haunting me. And they always find out where I am and make a point of evicting that first.
Mike, the cabinet was on that shelf there. Where's it gone?
It's now in my pocket.
So is it a personal thing then?
Yeah, I think it is. I take it all very personally. I don't think they're particularly interested in building a road at all. That's yours, isn't it, Carl?
There's the hammer and nails for sealing the door, if it comes to that. And there's the back window for getting out.
So the only thing you don't seem to have in here then, seems you've got your TV, your window, you haven't got the kitchen.
We've got food.
Right.
We do have a large amount of food.
Great. So between the bunkers and the scaffold tower, I'm fairly confident that the Department of Transport's rather obvious attempt at news management, namely carrying out this eviction at the same time as the budget, ain't going to work, because we're still going to be here on Wednesday. Mm.
Stop the car on the roof. Spare kit.
I got onto the street at 5 in the morning and I got ever so fed up. Because I was just, it was chilly. I feel the cold badly and I was cold and I was just standing and standing and standing. They didn't come till 2 o'clock. And I had a collapse. I mean, I just blew my brain. I wanted to go home and do the homework for my evening class and play my piano and read my books and sit on my comfortable chairs and be human. I had had it, you know, I had really absolutely had it. My gut just twisted. I went into one of the houses and lay on the floor and bawled for a bit. And then I got up and went and stood on the road again because I'd done it. I had done, you know, the awful anxiety. But also the sheer fed-upness with the inhuman life of just standing on a road waiting for someone to come and maul you around. And I went and stood on the road, and then I wanted to walk away and go home. I'm sick of all this. And then the troops came onto the street, and I knew which side I was on because I was just screaming, "Get off our street, get off our street." If I said, "Dare you come on our street," and then I knew who I was and where I belonged.
Heard them crying out. We've heard the police pushing the people and they're shouting at, you know, be careful and that. But it's really frightening in here because we feel like sardines, just waiting for the lid to come off and explode. We've heard that the lock-ons are holding up very, very well. And I'm amazed to think how well these people outside are holding on.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Absolutely brilliant.
They do. They've got hearts of gold, these people. When you consider what they're doing it for. Just so that everybody can have a safe haven.
Yeah, there's still a few people trying to sort of get back in.
It's going to be quite difficult. There's more fucking police here than the whole of the Met, I think. Yes, I heard. Is it possible they could see if Vicky could take it out?
Yeah, well, this is what we're hoping. This is what we're thinking about.
Protesters on the road were the first to be removed, followed quickly by our cameraman, and slowly but surely everyone else was forced to go. Though it was largely peaceful and there was no arrests, residents and protesters were angry.
There are police absolutely everywhere in riot gear. Can you believe it? This is a non-violent protest.
No, I'm not very happy about this at all. There's a lot of people, local people here today who are very angry about this.
As protesters continue to be removed by bailiffs and police, those inside the buildings in Claremont Road have barricaded themselves in. Towering above the skyline, scaffolding has been erected to slow the contractors down. Underground, some lay in tunnels covered with rubble.
Look at it.
I've seen that before.
Oh, no! No!
I'm just going to
play on TV.
Constance,
Just when we were
Mum's cooking dinner.
People have stayed up, been awake now for 24 hours, totally freezing cold, but they're still making a huge effort just to kind of, and still struggling for every kind of, every bit of, every room, every sort of house, every roof, and people have been running about in the nets with bare feet after their shoes have been taken off, and I mean, people, I think the thing is that there's just a massive determination of, well, there's probably about 300 people yesterday, there's probably about 200 left, and there's just this huge determination of people who've just been on the phone tree and come down not knowing what to expect and not really particularly being prepared well, and they've just sort of cottoned on to the feeling and they're as determined as anyone else to kind of hang out.
We missed one little opportunity. We had a couch and we'd nearly done it. That was to, in the middle of the day when the shifts were changing, there was quite a big gap at the front. Would have been nice to open the front door and run a couch out into the middle of Claremont and just sit in it until they all started to charge towards you and then run in and do your portcullis down again. Which you got that cheeky about yourself. You just had to, didn't you? Any moment, you just didn't have that moment to spare. You was either thought, I've got two oranges left there and half a candle here. Who's on the roof and where's me lock on thing? And like there was so much on you to be in touch with. And always depending on what tactics they were using to wear you down. And you forever built yourself back up.
You've got no right to be carrying a weapon like that.
Stop here, not people!
Chapter, each page is being written by young people who believe simply in what they're doing and the direction that they've got. It's not taking anybody out, it's not accusing anyone of anything. It's just quite frankly saying we realise what the environment is and we're warning you that you're damaging it.
Thank you.
regardless of what happens at this dreadful road in the end, I think it was an extraordinary historical event. I think only history will really know what this road and this road protest was about. I think it's impossible for us to see it. But I think it served to give enormous encouragement and inspiration to an awful lot of other people.
When they cut down a sweet chestnut tree in December 93, they said, you know, they thought that they'd cut down the symbol of the campaign, they'd cut down the campaign that went with it. They were wrong. They cut us down in Wanstonia again. They were wrong again. They thought third time lucky at Claremont Road and we're still here.
Change the way we think, take the blinkers from us.